Were you guys playing 2K, and outside of your own storyline on your respective year, what were your thoughts as my career has progressed through the years to what it is now with 2K21?
Well, as the granddaddy of this stuff, man, 2K11, it was just the press conferences. You know, it was all audio. I auditioned for this thing in a closet at my house. I had a bad day, and all of a sudden they called me in. I went up there, I did it. It was a fun game because it had so many different personalities. It was like choose your own adventure.
Traffic heading in and out of downtown Minneapolis, Minnesota. The setting for our broadcast tonight. Welcome, everyone, to a brand new season of NBA basketball. I'm sure you're as excited as all of us are here at 2K Sports as we get ready to start the season in style. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. D.A., it's all yours.
Kevin, good evening. Karl Anthony Towns is certainly the franchise player now for the Timberwolves. Kat said, you lead by action and you lead by words. I'm more of the action guy. When things get tough, I've got to be the guy that leads the charge. Kevin, he knows his role and he knows his place atop the Wolves franchise.
Knows it very well, D.A. Thank you so much. Here's what the Minnesota Timberwolves have lined up on their schedule. On Saturday, they'll face off against Donovan Mitchell and the Utah Jazz. And then on Sunday, they'll face off against Anthony Davis and the Los Angeles Lakers.
And, you know, nobody loves playing on the road, but it does offer a good chance to see exactly what your team is made of. This team is going to find out a lot about itself over the next stretch of games.
And now the opening lineup for Detroit. They've got Griffin. He's out there with Wright. Then there's Plumlee, and it's Grant in at the three. And for Minnesota, Karl Anthony Towns is out there with Lehman. Then there's D'Angelo Russell. Then it's Malik Beasley. And it's Okogie in at the three slot. And it's the Pistons to start out. Greg, you played over a decade in the NBA. Is there an opening day that you remember most that sticks out in your mind?
No doubt. The very first time I put on that Knicks jersey, you know, your rookie year. The game was in Orlando. I got to play 28 minutes, which was a lot for a rookie back then, especially on a really good team. And it was an awesome experience. That was a moment you had dreamt of your entire life if you grew up wanting to play basketball, man. And I was pumped.
That's a great story. And so it's the Pistons getting on the board first. Beasley kicks to Towns. It's good from long range.
And few seven-footers in the league have Towns' shooting touch. This is a guy you want to create for time and time again.
Now here's Hayes. Plumlee, and it's slammed in by Plumlee.
Great pass to set your man up with a high percentage look.
Outside, Russell. And Towns, the bucket on the assist by Russell. Towns has got 5 points so far.
And I like to see this. They're calling his number early, and he's delivering.
It makes sense, right? You're trying to get off to a fast start, and he can help with that.
Here's Hayes. Drops in the tray.
Great look by Blake Griffin. When your foreman has that ability to pass the basketball, it's a major advantage.
Here's Russell with the three. Plumlee with the rebound.
Definitely a situation you want to make sure you don't give him too good of a look.
Plenty of daylight on that shot. 6 points for him.
A lot of enthusiasm to the start of this game. So far, a perfect 4 for 4.
Here's Russell. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
And, you know, we talk about feel and reading the situation. Russell gets an opening there and does not flinch.
Pass to Plumlee, right wing. He lobs up the alley-oop pass. Now here's Beasley. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Dallas.
He was really aggressive on the glass, too. He really racked up on the boards out there.
here in the first. Just under 2.5 minutes played so far. The jumper from the free throw line is good.
And that pick takes the D totally out of the equation. Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
Now here's Hayes. 6 points for him. Griffin inside, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
Against physical defense, Griffin showing off his power. Nice play.
And when he first came into the league, Blake Griffin's dunking made headlines. And while I'm sure he enjoyed that, he was also eager to show that there was more to his game.
Now, here is Russell. Shot clock at 6. Okogie inside the 3-point line. Jump shot is good that time. And Detroit has possession. And you know, Greg, in the past, Griffin felt at times criticized as being a one-dimensional player.
I tell you, Kevin, I think he's answered those critics. You look at his passing and his development as a shooter, one of the more complete offensive players in the league. And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher. And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
And I look back at his numbers from the free throw line last year, 78%, so not too bad.
Here's what Minnesota's going with right now. Juan Hernan Gomez, he's checked in for Lehman. Edwards comes in for Josh Okogie. And Ricky Rubio is subbed in for Malik Beasley. A free throw drops for Griffin.
I mean, hard to fathom that Blake Griffin is becoming one of the more prolific three-point shooters among NBA big men.
Greg, it was a shot he barely attempted through his first 6 seasons in the league. Now he's made it a key part of his arsenal.
Left side, Rose. Pass to Mykhailiuk. Rose with the ball. He's picked up by Russell. Rose passes to Bay. Sinks it. What range from outside. Wow.
Yeah, those are starting to add up, guys. Up their last 5 baskets, 3 have been triples.
Here's Rubio. Now the pass to Hernan Gomez. He dishes it to Russell. Just 5 on the clock. The shot's good.
An active competitor, Russell won't go down without a fight, especially around the rim.
And Rose throws it down hard.
Incredible. D. Rose steal with great lift. Breaks out a dunk he's probably been working on for a while.
Russell passes to Edwards. Out to Russell. Here's the 3. Rebound by the Pistons. Now Rose. 14 points from him the last game against Washington.
Yeah, and I look at his total effect on the scoring, both as a passer and a shooter. Incredibly productive.
Here is Rubio, following the basket by Blake Griffin. Russell finds Towns. Back to Russell. Good, and the assist goes to Towns. Russell's got his 3rd basket of the night.
And look at Russell bringing the intensity. He's stronger now, willing to mix it up inside no matter who's on him.
Now here's Griffin. He's got 7, and that one drops.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Timberwolves trail by 9. Outside, Russell. We've got 1:18 left to play here in the first, and they pick up 2.
In this period, they're feeding him, and he's feeling it.
And so it's Rose bringing it up for the Pistons. Passes it to Okafor. Back to Rose. Goes up to the stripe. Second shot opportunity. And the rejection by Towns. Here's Russell. And again it's Minnesota.
Taking things into his own hands this quarter. Trying to keep his team afloat.
Okafor kicks to Rose. And finished off by Rose.
Derrick Rose is a guard, but he dunked that one like a big fella.
2-for-1 chance here.
Let's see if they use the clock to their advantage.
Outside, Towns. And Griffin sends it back. Pass to Mykhailiuk. Nice D from Russell. Timberwolves trail. It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Rubio looking it over. Here's Towns. That's in, coming off an assist from Rubio. Towns has got 7 points in the game. Rose against Rubio. Out to the wing. A nice shot by Mykhailiuk.
Boy, both teams racking up the points to start this game.
And you wonder how long they can keep it going. At some point, you expect the defense will adjust.
And so it's the Detroit Pistons heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. Their shooting has been the big key. Their percentage from the field so far has been terrific. And don't go away. We'll be right back. And recently, D'Angelo Russell, Greg, told us about some offseason work he put in.
And I picked a lot of people's brains, you know, going into the summer, a lot of guys that have made that jump, paved the way for us, a lot of older guys. And, you know, the answer that they were giving me was figuring out that routine that your body needs, that your mind needs to prepare for each game. And once I started getting in that consistent routine of napping, eating, my pregame meal, things of that sort, it kind of started to come for me.
Greg doing what he can do to reach that immense potential.
You know, the talent is there. There's never been a question about that, but you also have to be reliable and accountable, both to yourself and to your team. Sounds like that's becoming his focus.
And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And guys, what's your take on the Pistons so far?
Hey, why take jump shots when you can get your points at the rim?
Especially at the start. You want to get something positive going and establish your rhythm.
On the floor for Detroit, we've got Derrick Rose. Jahlil Okafor is out there with Doumbouya. And it's Bay in at the three spot. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. The Timberwolves were fined last season for resting D'Angelo Russell on the road in a nationally televised game. Minnesota said, "We're a player-centric organization that's focused on learning and optimizing our players' bodies. Guys, they do seem willing to pay a fine here or there to protect their players' health." Back to you.
Well, as a player, how couldn't you like that? Always watching out for you. David, thank you for that one. Bay. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
Rubio, right side. Six on the shot clock. Pass to Culver. Another miss by Minnesota. Detroit leading by 8. And it's stolen by Ricky Rubio. Here's Edwards, and Edwards with the stuff.
And that whole play starts with Rubio's anticipation. Have to protect the ball around him.
Detroit's gone 3-of-3 from three-point land here tonight. And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here. Teams have dynasties, the 90s, Michael Jordan. We've seen it over the many decades. Over the next decade, though, who do you think's going to lead the pack there, Greg?
Oh, that's a great question. You know, with the way Father Time is treating LeBron, you might have to wait and see because he is still playing at such a high level. But, you know, obviously Giannis has got to be on the short list with the Bucks. For me, I really look at Luka in Dallas. I just feel like with Kristaps Porzingis, that duo could just be deadly with how the game is played. But don't sleep on the Celtics with Tatum and Brown and that group that they have with the front office they have. Man, I think the league overall is going to be in great shape moving forward.
It sure seems that way. Here's what Minnesota's going with right now. Okogie comes in for Ricky Rubio, and it's Beasley in for Edwards. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Plumlee.
Unforced errors. These are the kinds of things that break momentum.
How about that mobile one block we just saw? Amazing defensive work.
And those are plays that get you in front and keep you in front.
Timberwolves trail by six. Here's Okogie. And there's the pass to Beasley. And another three for Minnesota.
You know, maybe he's not one of the elite sharpshooters, but even still, that's not a shot that D can afford to give him.
Here's Wright. And Wright throws it down hard.
And once he gets clear off the screen, there is no stopping him.
No, not when there's a flush waiting to happen.
That's a big-time move and a big-time finish.
Now here's Beasley. He's got five. Here's Lehman. Dishes to Culver. Five on the clock. Lets it go from deep. He can't get that one. And Detroit the other way now. Their biggest lead of the game was nine. Following this one, they get to host the Cavaliers. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again.
Playing with high energy, outworking the defense up the floor.
And I just love it when the fast break results in a high percentage look. Not always the case these days.
And how about the balance there from Culver? Really good at staying in control despite the D being all over.
And we know GA's shooting is a question mark for Jarrett Culver.
A long windup, a little hitch in his giddy up, and shoots it kind of on the way down. He's reworked his motion. I like the high release, but it's still a work in progress.
A wide open look here for Wright, and another three for Detroit.
Shutout in the first quarter. He's heating up now. I like the aggressiveness.
Inside, and the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
Strong move to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
The problem is your opponent is making big plays as well. I'll be curious to see the response.
No hesitation at all on the alley-oop. Saw his teammate with a pat to the hoop, and bang, lobbed it right up there for him to finish.
And he was ready for it when he elevated and made the catch. So the Timberwolves called their first timeout.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
And it boils down to the question, toughness. One team showing it, the other allowing itself to be bullied.
Griffin's checked in for Dumboya. Timberwolves trail by eight. Pass to Towns.
Possessing the touch. From there, I like when Towns shows off that smooth mid-range game.
Detroit's gotten off four shots from three-point range tonight and buried every one of them. Pass to Grant. Towns against Plumlee. Outside Griffin. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
When you think of low post scores, you got to put Griffin down there. Yes, he likes to face up, but with his back to the basket, he's pretty good as well as drawing fouls.
This is his second trip to the free throw line.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good.
You know, in high school, he won four state titles, voted College Player of the Year at Oklahoma. Blake Griffin, he's used to success.
Both free throws good from Griffin. Greg is a broadcaster. Who have been some of your favorite personalities to cover?
Man, that's a great question. You know, most of the stars, I'm a big fan of Durant and Steph and LeBron and those guys. Chris Paul's another one that's a favorite. So many other guys, you know, there's so much more personality and so much more confidence these guys have working in front of the camera. I think that just makes for a better experience.
Somebody asked me the other day, who is my favorite? You know who I said?
Who was that?
Greg Anthony.
Oh, you're just saying that because it's true.
Hernan Gomez passes to Beasley, and it's Wright sending it back. Now Detroit moving it up. Grant leading the charge. Shot from the wing. No good from Beasley. Hayes with it. He's picked up by Russell. Throws it up high. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. Pass to Beasley. Launches a three. Buries the long-range jumper. Beasley's got six here in this quarter.
And they're shooting really well from long range this quarter. They should keep looking to the three-point shot for some extra offense.
Goes up at the stripe. And again, it's the Pistons missing. Looking at the last game for the Minnesota Timberwolves, it was a win against the Mavericks in Dallas. And it's Russell missing.
Well, that alley-oop attempt, a case of what could have been, just didn't finish the play.
You know, this is something you practice over and over again. I'm surprised they couldn't execute.
Outside Russell, from deep, and another three for Minnesota.
So shifty with the ball in his hands. Russell changes pace with the best of them.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Driven against Hernan Gomez.
I tell you what, the defense should send Christmas cards for that miss.
Okogie for three. Good on the triple. And now just a three-point Piston lead.
Great timing. That can be the difference between an assist and a turnover.
To the left side wing. Here's Griffin. Count the bucket. And he's got a free throw coming up as well.
I love the way a Griffin, eye on the prize, going after the rim, is either you're going to dunk it or you're going to foul him.
Pistons have gone 3-for-3 at the line tonight. Blake Griffin getting it done for Detroit. He finishes with 9 points in the quarter. The D is having all sorts of problems with him. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Derek, how's it feel to be back on the floor again?
It feels good, man, especially playing with my teammates. We have new teammates. We're just trying to come out here and just play hard and compete.
Good to see you back out here, Derek. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, and we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny, and a favorite time of the year as we're halfway through one of the first games of this fresh NBA season. Some incredible work in this one by Blake Griffin. He had 18 points, 2 rebounds, and 1 block. This has been a bounce-back game for him after some struggles their last time out. Kenny, what's your take on Detroit so far?
You talk about power players with skill? That's Blake Griffin. He's shooting well, and he's an intimidating physical presence. Did a great job of setting the tone early.
Shaq, what'd you think about Minnesota?
Ernie, I love you. I gotta be honest. That was an awful first half. Giving up over 60% from the field? Come on, Ernie. Wow. They stayed in it. Maybe it'll give them a little extra motivation they need to fix their defense.
Thanks for joining us, folks. We're now just a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. You look at Blake Griffin in this game, he's been everywhere.
And he's shown just how adept he can be at creating contact and then cashing in at the line.
It's a part of his game that he can always tap into. There's an art to it, and he is painting the canvas tonight.
Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game that's been so far. Layman is out there with Carl Anthony Towns. Then it's Malik Beasley. And there's D'Angelo Russell. And it's Okogie in at the small forward. That's the group starting the second half for Ryan Saunders. And we just got a second look there at the exceptional Mobile One block.
And that'll give him a jolt. Nothing like a rejection to light a fire under you.
The pass to Hayes. Pistons passing it around. Plumlee in the post. Defended by Towns. The shot's good from Plumlee.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Passes it to Okogie. Towns down low. Working on Plumlee. For three, Okogie. Detroit with the rebound. Plumlee's got 7 rebounds in the game.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, Blake Griffin had 2 more knee surgeries last season. Pistons coach Dwayne Casey said that the year before, they rode him like a cheap horse, in Casey's words, to make the playoffs. Griffin acknowledged his load may need managing down the road, saying, I'm a believer in science. I'm going to listen to them and let them lead the way.
Take
guys,
a break. Take a
smart
break.
Perspective. Two David, shot. Thank you. And he knocks down the first one. Greg, you were drafted 12th overall by the New York Knicks and then 2nd overall by the Grizzlies in the expansion draft. So you've had a very unique view of being in that position in 2 different settings.
Yeah, I mean, 2 very different cities, but really each beautiful in its own way. The New York draft, obviously coming out of college, that was like a dream come true to go and play for Pat Riley and then get the opportunity to go and be a part of a brand new team in a new country, if you will, was also a really cool experience as well.
I hope we can take a petition started by you and me to get the NBA back in Vancouver. I miss
and
going
Seattle,
to Vancouver.
Right? Let's get back
oh,
in
and
both
Seattle.
Those cities.
Exactly. First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
And at the line last year, he was good on about 77% of his attempts.
And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. Russell passes to Towns. Beasley outside. Down low. Here's Russell. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Russell's got 15.
Terrific play call to give him a clean look at the rim. That's how you want to start the second half.
Listen, put the ball in the hands of your best scorers and let them go to work. Keep it simple.
Ooh. Oh, inflicting some punishment with the 2-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. Tipped away and stolen by Wright. Grant, that's good. Grant's got the lead up to 11 now for the Pistons. Minnesota's gone 6 of 11 when they've taken the 3-point shot tonight. Very respectable. Plumlee against Towns.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
And it's Wright missing. And so it's Russell with it. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. It's off to Utah for him after this game as they take on the Jazz. That's game 1 of a 3-game road trip. Pass to Okogie. Towns against Plumlee. And it's Towns missing. Pistons leading by 11.
And the Timberwolves have made it clear Karl Anthony Towns is their franchise player. He's the guy they're building around.
And out of bounds as the Timberwolves gain possession. And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Reed's checked in. And Culver's subbed in for Russell. And Detroit with a change here, too. Dumboya's checked in for Mason Plumlee. And we've heard Towns for years pronouncing his happiness with the Timberwolves. Last season, Greg, as the losses piled up, some rumors that he was getting frustrated.
Well, we've seen this pattern with the Timberwolves before, right? Kevin Garnett, Kevin Love, all-star big man who ended up leaving the Twin Cities to win titles.
Edwards, he's checked in for Josh Okogie. Then for the Pistons, Makai Lucas checked in, and it's Rose in for Wright. Three minutes gone now in the third quarter. Outside Griffin. Here's Dumboya. It's blocked. It's Beasley on the wing, covered by Hayes. Shoots it. And it's Griffin with the rebound. Griffin's got his fourth rebound in this one. Pass to Mikhailuk. Now Hayes. And here's Rose. Makes it off the glass. Rose has got his third basket of the night right there.
And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
To the middle, here's Reed. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
Yeah, the D has not been able to keep the ball out of the paint at that end of the floor.
Hayes the pass to Mikhailuk. A three ball, and Lehman pulls it down.
And even without that three ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
And denied, he sends it right off the glass. Here's Rose, drains the jumper to finish the break. Rose has got 8 points.
In the mid-range. Rarely the hallmark of efficiency in today's NBA, but it is on point tonight.
And the Timberwolves call time here. Blake Griffin really making a difference here.
Good decision to regather, talk it over. Your main concern now is how to slow this guy down on the offensive end.
Both teams will make substitutions. The 2K leaderboard provides us now with this list of last season's assist leaders. Ricky Rubio is fourth.
Very few guys pass the ball better than he did. I mean, he didn't just have eyes in the back of his head. It's almost as if he had them on both sides, too.
Rubio with it. He's covered by Rose. Rubio with it. No points in the game yet for him. Okafor with the steal. Here's Mikhailuk. Edwards defending. Now the pass to Okafor. Back to Rose. Pistons passing it around. Six to shoot. Tries again. Here's Okafor. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
And here we have an opportunity to check out Karl Anthony Towns. He's coming off an excellent season, putting up about 26 points per, 11 rebounds and 4 assists. And no secret, he can score the ball, number one on the team last year.
He loves being the go-to guy. You can see it in his swagger. And boy, he sure lit it up last season.
And he can't get the first one. D'Angelo Russell's checked in for Minnesota. He hits the second from the line. Here's Rubio. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Stolen by Jumboya. Now here's Rose. The fast break opportunity. And he caps off the fast break with a monster slam.
Great court awareness by Derrick Rose. Reading every inch of the floor so well.
1:32 left to play in the third. Back to Russell. That counts. He's put up 13 shots, and he's had 8 of those go in.
Playing from behind right here, not easy, but he is answering the bell.
The reason why is not just scoring. It's the way he's doing it. Efficient. That's what you need at this point in the game.
And it's Okafor missing. Timberwolves trail by 14. From deep. And Russell gets it to go on the assist from Edwards. Russell's got 20.
And this team's struggles are not his fault. He's putting in work at the offensive end.
Kicks to Jumboya. Passes it to Rose. Over Rubio. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is good. Rose has got 6 in the quarter.
He's been a big factor in their offense tonight, making shot after shot.
Russell from long range. And again, Minnesota with the triple.
All about converting your opportunities. He just hit his 2nd 3 of this half, 3rd of the night.
And it's Rose penetrating, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and 2 shots coming up.
And as he gets older, we've seen Derrick Rose coming out of his shell a bit more. Early in his career, he was wary of strangers and the media.
This is his first free throw of the game. And he makes the first.
Explosiveness by Derrick Rose is one of the reasons why a lot of guys do not want to guard him.
Detroit making a switch here. Grant's checked in. And both free throws good for Rose.
Money from the stripe. He does a great job night in and night out.
Russell passes to Edwards. 23 seconds left to play in the third. Here's Hernan Gomez. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. Russell's got 3 assists in the game. And so it's Rose who brings the ball up for Detroit. At one point, they led by 16. And finished off by Rose.
Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury.
And he rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish.
And the way they have controlled the glass this game, really impressive.
You know, you look at how they built this lead. It's been through extra possessions.
Mm-hmm.
And so is Detroit, up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter. What a night they've had in terms of their shooting. Everything dropping in for them. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
And he sliced the D wide open with his feet. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
Creating plays for others, it's an art form, but it's also a discipline. Fantastic job.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. And Detroit, looking at who they've got. They've got Plumlee. Rose is out there with Jeremy Grant. And it's Bay in at the three, the small forward. A nice shot by Mykhailiuk.
Slicing and dicing, Derrick Rose picking the defense apart with the pass.
Timberwolves trail by 15. Pass to Towns. Sinks that one from the post.
There were a lot of ways he could have finished that one, but he's decided to keep it classy with the finger roll.
Rubio against Rose. He kicks to Grant. Trying to find Towns. Gets it to him. Russell feeling it out a bit. Pass to Rubio. Here's Okogie. The feed now to Towns. No good that time.
Yeah, and they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really, right from the tip. Their rebounding edge right now, massive. Late reaction defensively. He quickly takes advantage, grows their lead.
You can't afford to give him space. Those kinds of mistakes have been the story of this game.
Rubio misses. Detroit leading by 16. Here's Rose. Count that one as his seventh make in eight attempts. A scorching 88%.
And he's shaking off that slow start, giving them a boost here in the second.
Now, here's Rubio. Rebounded by Rose. Rose has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Yes, that goes in. And the Pistons lead by 20.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
This has been an impressive performance tonight. Even with a big lead, they've maintained their focus.
Here's Towns.
Rubio.
Lock at six. Yep, it counts.
Because of his size and how he can adjust, Russell really proficient at hitting the contested J.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
And as fans and broadcasters, we're not permitted to hear the specifics in these huddles.
No, we're left to infer from the adjustments we see on the floor.
The Timberwolves making a switch here. Beasley's checked in. Detroit leading by 18. The pass to Grant. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. To the inside. And the dunk by Grant.
They just won't miss. I mean, this is incredible.
Good shooting can be contagious. You see the confidence running through this team right now.
Now, here is Russell. Hayes with the steal. Towns with the defensive effort. The Timberwolves have gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Beasley, the pass to Towns. Over Hayes. And it's Towns missing.
High percentage look for him. But bottom line, they're not all going to go down.
Here's Wright, and the rejection by Towns.
And his foot movement is what makes Towns such a terrific shot blocker. He moves so well and can defend just about any position on the floor.
The offense was firing on all cylinders, and that's the exact kind of shot they wanted.
Wright outside. Now, here's Grant. Here's Hayes, and it's sent back by Russell. Passes to Lehman. Shoots over Grant. That one rolling around and rims out.
It's a shot you would think he would make, but he just doesn't make it all the time.
Now Hayes. Back to Grant. Just 5 to shoot. And it's in there. Here's Hayes. Out to the right wing. Outside Griffin. Knocked loose. And it's Wright with the ball for Detroit. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. Outside Griffin. And the slam by Blake Griffin.
Wanted to attack all evening. Not sure at this point what can slow Blake Griffin down.
Minnesota calls timeout. And now we present our New Balance player of the game, Derrick Rose.
Yeah, and his percentage from the field tonight seems almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
Teams need contributions from everybody to win on the road, not just the stars. And he's done more than his share tonight, an outstanding performance. Timberwolves trail by 18. Russell passes to Towns. Beasley outside. Shot clock at 6. Minnesota needs to get off a shot here. And the basket by Okogie. 1:53 left in the fourth quarter. Right against Beasley. Grant outside. Kicks to Rose. 6 on the shot clock. Outside Griffin. Shoots a 3. Minnesota with the rebound.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for Detroit.
Free throws were a big factor in this one.
You know, it's always great to get a lot of shots at the line, but the key, they were able to convert tonight. You start making free throws, and it can get you the win.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year. And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for Derrick Rose.
A big part of their success was his ability to keep the ball moving, finding guys when they would flash open.
Rose kicks to Griffin. And the slam by Blake Griffin.
Yeah, they've sucked the energy out of this arena. Tremendous effort on the road.
And when you're on the road, you can't be tentative coming into a game like this. I thought their aggressive approach was the difference.
The long arms, the positioning. Towns is excellent at knowing how to gobble up those second chance opportunities.
Rose in the post. He's guarded by Russell.
Taking no chances, they go on one last run to seal the deal.
Not messing around at all. They were focused, relentless, and they got the job done.
Attention to detail is what's helped Russell improve his scoring ability every year.
Right outside. Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Russell against Rose. And the rejection by Towns. And it's out of bounds. The Pistons able to retain possession here. Twelve seconds left in the fourth quarter. 6 to shoot. Here's McDaniels. And so Detroit takes this one by a big margin.
And in the win, a comfortable win in what was, I think, gee, a pretty hostile environment.
It really was. You know, it's never going to be easy on the road, but they didn't have too many problems with that tonight.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.